Hello folks, this is Ayat Tanaja from inspiredrise.com, and I have been using the Honor 7X since a month now, and I found quite a lot of things about the smartphone. What's good about it, what's bad about it, what needs to be improved, and today I'm going to share all of that with you. About this phone which catches your eye is the design. So it has got quite a good design. If you look at it closely, all of the sides are very rounded, feels a lot like the iPhone 7, but still it has its own feel to it if you look at the Maxview display. So almost a 6-inch display packs a 1080p resolution, 1080p plus resolution, 2160 by 1080 in an 18:9 form factor, which makes it quite a good phone to hold and to watch content on. It also has all of the software controls required in order to maximize the viewing estate to the whole 18:9 whenever you're watching 16:9 content. So that's also something good. The color reproduction is on point and the display looks good. Experience on the Huawei Honor phone is quite smooth, fluid. The EmUI that they have, it's still the same. I guess this is my greatest issue with the Honor smartphone, that even after 3 or 4 generations of Honor smartphones, the UI still looks the same. These guys should go on with the material design guidelines by Google, try to make the UI a little bit different from what was already there. I know that you can install an icon pack, you can install something like Nova Launcher, make it really different, but for all of the other people who are going to buy this phone, it should look a little bit different after so many generations of Honor smartphones. And I think that's one of the biggest issues that I personally have. It's not that much of an issue. That's the only qualm that I have with this phone, that they could have improved the UI by just changing a little bit of the elements here and there, and it could have been a lot better experience. I am not saying that it's not better now, but it could have been much better than this. This does not even look as smooth, as good as stock Android, as slick as stock Android. If you check Android 8.0 Oreo, the icons look definitely a lot better than this. So if Google has implemented something like material design guidelines, they should have been there. I've been using this smartphone for 1 month now, and I think most of the times I just installed Nova Launcher on it, and I tried custom icons and launchers because I didn't quite like the look. And now let's move forward to the other points. Does that affect the usability of this phone in any way? No, it does not affect the usability in any way. The phone is still quite good, works really nice, and if you are going to use it on a day-to-day basis, the battery life also holds up. It has around 3300 plus mAh battery, which holds up for a full day of usage. But if you're a very heavy user, you might want to charge your smartphone by the end of the day. Because of the fact that Honor belongs to a huge company like Huawei, they have really good chipsets and they have really good antenna design. So if you are talking about something like call quality, signal reception, these are all very well done on the Honor 7X smartphone. And it's the case with almost every other smartphone by Huawei, by Honor, that they have really good antennas and the whole cellular radio present inside these phones. That's quite good. If you talk about what's inside, it comes with the Octa Core Kirin 659 chipset, and the numbers don't matter in this case. The clock speed is quite good. I have to tell you about this because when you are running benchmarks, when you are running games, running applications, doing heavy multitasking, it all runs very fluidly, and you have 4 GB of RAM, 64 GB of internal storage on this variant that I'm using. There's also the 3 GB RAM, 32 GB storage variant, and I have to test that variant. A lot of companies have a history of having smartphones with lesser storage, having lesser access speeds. So if that's the same for the Honor 7X, I am not sure about it. I have to test a 32 GB storage variant in order to be sure about it, but I hope that's not the case here. But there's a significant price difference between both of the storage models, so I guess this assumption could be right in this case.
And now let's talk about the cameras for this device. It comes with a 16 megapixel plus 2 megapixel camera combination at the back, and I have to say that though it's not something really out of the park, it's still good, it performs good. You get that awesome bokeh effect while shooting photos, but when it comes to the portrait bokeh, which is done via software, I think the hair and the few of the clothes, etc., they're still not properly, the edge is still not properly fixed in those. This blurring on the edges, the hair is quite blurred out. And I guess they have to learn a thing or two from software optimization done by Google on their Pixel smartphones. That kind of AI is something that is not fully present on something like the Honor 7X. And though the Honor 7X with the hashtag of IOOI, it's quite good. The pictures that come out of it are quite good, but if I talk about the camera on a very objective basis, there's no 4K video support, there's no EIS or OIS fully built in, so when you're taking videos, a lot of them would be shaky if you're walking around, and the 1080p videos shot on these are quite limited, the bitrate is not that high, so I think that's because the chipset limitation comes in at some points. And if you talk about the front camera is only limited up to 720p video recording, and I think that's one of the biggest qualms for those people who are going to use the front camera for shooting videos. The video quality is not that great when compared to a lot of other smartphones in the similar price range. The 32GB variant of the Honor 7X would retail for a price of around 13,000 rupees. The 64GB variant would retail for a price of 16,000 rupees. And I think that the price difference between these two is quite high, considering the fact that there is only bump in the RAM and the storage. They must have their own reasons behind this decision, but I guess most of the people would opt for the 3GB RAM and 32GB storage variant. And I feel that Honor should have done the pricing a little bit lesser for the 64GB variant, but I still feel that considering the form factor of the product, the build quality, which is very smooth pebble-like finish, it's very handy and the design is very fluid, the experience is quite good. So if you think about all of that, then it kind of makes sense for Honor to sell a smartphone like this at 13,000. I think that for this price, this is one of the best smartphones that you can get, and even with 3GB of RAM, the EMUI experience is quite optimized. You won't feel so many hiccups or issues. But if you're somebody who wants a slightly better camera, a better performing bokeh mode, so you can look at something like the Moto G5S Plus or the Mi A1. But still, those smartphones also don't look this good, don't have this Maxview display, which is I guess one of the biggest things that you spend your time on. If you are using a smartphone, you're going to spend most of your time using the display, and if you are going to use a display, why not use something like an 18:9 aspect ratio display which looks this good. So I think that if you think about all of those things, if you think about the initial launch offers with the bundled data packs and everything, then the Honor 7X makes perfect sense for anybody who is going to buy a budget smartphone. There are issues, there are cons, but all of those are not really something which can affect or hinder your purchase decision. So guys, this was it for this video. In case you like this one, don't forget to smash the thumbs up button. Do subscribe to Inspired Rise for more awesome detailed tech reviews like this one. And guys, no matter what you do, stay inspired to rise.